Let us pray.
Our
Father, we thank you for the assurance and the confidence. And we thank you for reminding us that Jesus Christ died to take all our sins away.
Baba wa ti nbe lorun adupe lowo yin fun idaniloju ati fi okan bale ti e ran wa leti pe Jesu ku fun ese wa.
We are praying, O Lord, that you will apply this blood in every heart, every life here present tonight, that all the guilt of sin, all the condemnation of sin, the pollutions and the penalty of sin, everything will be taken away by the blood of the Lamb in Jesus' name.
An gbadura Oluwa wi pe e lo eje yi lati ta si gogo okan to be ege to je pe gogo aba won ninu okan idalebi ese ninu okan ati idibaje to wa ninu okan e o we gogo re mo ni oruko Jesu.
We pray there will be a living faith, a strong faith, a steady faith, an abiding faith in every one of us to know that the blood of Jesus Christ has dealt finally with every form of sin, and we should drop everything and cling to that blood in Jesus' name.
Ambe yin Oluwa wi pe igbagbo to lagbara, igbagbo aye, igbagbo to nfun ni dani loju yo so ninu okan olukuluku lati je ki a mo wi pe eje Jesu ti yanju gbogbo ese patapata nipase be a o ju gbogbo re sile patapata loruko Jesu.
We pray that the study of your word tonight will strengthen every one of us in our faith, in our dependence upon you, in our relationship with you, in Jesus' name.
Ebe wa ni pe eko bibeli itale yi yo fun gbogbo wa lokun ninu gbigbekele yin ninu nini idaniloju ninu yin pe e ti to fun gbogbo fun wa.
Thank you, Lord, for the answer.
Adupe lowo yin fun idahun.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Ni oruko Jesu ni agbadura.
In our study of the scriptures, we come to Hebrews chapter 13 from verse 10 to verse 13.
Ninu eko ti an ko ninu iwe mimo arekoja si eberori ketala bayi lese ikewa si ketala.
Please open your Bible and as we read together, follow as we read on.
Jowo si bibeli re bi asije njumo ka papo ma foju ba lo.
We have an altar whereof they have no right to eat, which serve the tabernacle.
Awa ni pepe kan ninu eyi ti awon tin sin ago ko ni agbara lati ma je.
For the bodies of those beasts whose blood is brought into the sanctuary by the high priest for sin are burnt without the camp, outside the camp.
Nitori pe ara awon eran won ni eje yi ti olori alfa mu wa ti ibi mimo nitori ese asun won leyin budo.
Wherefore Jesus also, that he might sanctify the people with his own blood, suffered without the gate, outside the gate.
Nitori na Jesu pelu ki o le fi eje ara re so awon eniyan di mimo.
Let us go therefore unto him without the camp, outside the camp, bearing his reproach.
Nitori na eje ki a jade to lo leyin ibudo ki a ma ru egan re.
You know that as we have been studying the epistle to the Hebrews, the apostle, the inspired writer, has been contrasting the old covenant with the new covenant. And in making a comparison of the old and the new, he had been telling us that all the things pertaining to the old, they have been annulled, they have been cancelled, they have been abolished, taken away.
Iwe rẹ ti o se nipa majemu lailai ati majemu titun ohun to ntele wa to ntemo wa leti gbonmo ni wipe gbogbo nkan ti majemu lailai ni ati fagile.
And because he was saying that, the people might begin to wonder, if all those privileges of the old covenant had been taken away, what remains for the new covenant?
Nigba ti o wa so pe ati fagile gbogbo awon nkan wonyi awon to wa ba soro won le mo ni ipururu ninu okan won pe kin lo wa kunle fun wa ninu majemu lailai.
Because every Jewish person knew that in the old covenant you needed the blood, you needed the sacrifice, you needed the altar to be able to take away your sins. If the sins are not taken away, you cannot have relationship with the Lord Almighty.
Nitori pe gege bi omo Ju oyeye won gbangba wi pe ninu ibasepo won pelu Olorun won nilo eje won nilo pepe won nilo irubo.
The temple is no more. The altar is no more. The sacrifices are no more. So there will be a question in their mind. How then do you deal with the problem of sin? That's the reason he was telling them in verse 10, we have an altar.
Idi niyan to fi wa kegbanjari ni ese ikewa pe awa ni pepe kan.
The old altar had been abolished and taken away.
Pepe tatijo la fagile ti amukuro.
And yet we have an altar.
Sibe sibe awa ni pepe kan.
And once again I want to remind you.
Lekan si je ki ran leti.
He had been showing the superiority of the new covenant over the old covenant.
O tin toka won si olubori majemu titun lori majemu lai lai.
Is better than the old. Greater and higher than the old. Once again, now he wants to tell us that the New Testament and the New Covenant altar is higher, is greater, is better than the old.
Niba yo to wa pe to fi to won leti pe pepe ti ajemu tin tuntun o ga o lagbara ju ti majemu lai lai lo.
That's why he tells us in verse 10, whereof they, the people of the old covenant, they have no right to eat, which serve the covenant, the old covenant, the tabernacle of the old.
Ibinya to fi wa so pe ninu eyi ti awon iyan awon eyan majemu lai lai.
And then he tells us in verse 11, he brought them back to the old covenant, the sacrifices of the old covenant, the blood of the sacrifice of the old covenant. He said, for the bodies of those beasts whose blood is brought into the sanctuary by the high priest for sin are burnt outside the camp.
O so fun won gbangba pe nitori ara awon eran won ni eje yi ti olori alufa mu wa si ibi mimo nitori ese.
He was trying to remind them the efficacy of the blood in the old covenant. Number one, it made atonement for the sinners. Number two, he made them to escape the death penalty. Number three, they were granted cleansing from their
sins.
But then he needed to tell them that he needed to repeat all those sufferings often and often, because those sufferings could not make them perfect in every good work to do the will of the Father.
O wa lati ran won leti pe awon erubo yen ni won sin lati ma se ni gbogbo igba nitori pe awon erubo yen won ko je ki won ki o pe lati se ife baba ni pipe.
And now he reminded them that there is a new covenant.
O wa ran won leti pe majemu titun be o.
And the new covenant has a altar.
Majemu titun si ni pepe kan.
It has a lamb for sacrifice.
O ni odo agutan fun erubo.
And it has the blood of the new covenant as well. In verse 12, wherefore Jesus also, that he might sanctify the people with his own blood, he suffered without the gate. It all tells us the superiority of the blood of the New Testament lamb over the Old Testament lamb.
O wa so fun wa nipa olubori agbara nla ti eje majemu titun ni la lori eje ti lai lai.
Forgiveness of sin.
O fun wa ni idariji ese.
Remission, removal of sin.
Iwenu ma kuro ninu ese.
Giving us redemption by that blood.
O fun wa ni irapada nipase eje yi.
Giving us cleansing from all sin.
O nwe wa nu kuro nu gbogbo ese.
In fact, in this verse I just read to you now, it gives us sanctification.
Ninu ese ti mo sese ka tan yi o ti le fun wa ni isodi mimo.
And then in verse 20, verse 21 of this chapter, he makes us perfect in every good work to do the will of the Father. Freedom from outward sin and freedom from inward sin. He was trying to show them the great benefit we have, which is total freedom from sin and the fullness of our redemption through the blood of Jesus Christ, whereas what they had in the old covenant was a limited privilege which and now has been abolished, and the greater thing, the unlimited thing, has now come.
O so fun wa nipa anfani ti a wa ninu isisiyi nipa ti eje majemu titun ninu eyi to je pe a le so wa di mimo ninu ati lode eleyi to je pe majemu lai lai ko ni pa lati se.
Always remember as we study,
ma rati ni gbagbo bi a se nkeko,
everything they had in the old covenant we also have, and we have more.
Gbogbo ti won ba ni ninu majemu lai lai awa pelu ni ati eni ju won lo.
We're considering 3 points in our study today.
Awon koko meta ninu eko wa loni.
Number one, the old covenant sacrifices for sin.
Akoko ni irubo majemu lai lai fun ese.
Number two, Christ's sacrifice for our sanctification.
Ikeji ni irubo Christi fun isodi mimo wa.
Number three, our consecration and sacrifice for sanctification.
Eketa ni iyare ni soto ati ifare ni irubo wa.
Number one, he wants us to look at the old covenant sacrifices for sin.
Akoko ni pe o fe ki a wo irubo majemu lele fun ese.
Please come back to Hebrews chapter 13 verses 10 and 11.
Eje ka pada si Hebrews ori ketala ese ikewa ati ikokola.
It says we have an altar whereof they have no right to eat which serve the tabernacle.
O ni awa ni pepe kan ninu eyi ti awon tin sin ago ko le agbara lati ma je.
I told you that he's making a comparison.
Mo so fun e pe o se afiwe nibe.
It's telling us that the least in the kingdom of God now is greater than the highest in the old covenant.
O so gbangba pe ohun to kere julo ninu majemu titun bayi o ga ju ohun to ga ninu majemu lale.
In the old covenant you have the high priest.
Ninu majemu lale olori.
In the old covenant you have the Levites.
Ninu majemu lale ori awon
manle. And all those ministers and priests, they came and they offered sacrifices and they were a special group, better and higher, promoted higher than the generality of the children of Israel, and they could eat sacrifices which the others could not eat.
Àwọn ènìyàn yìí tí wọ́n jẹ́ ìránṣẹ́ Ọlọ́run wọ̀nyí a gbé wọn ga a fi wọn sì kú ọlá ju gbogbo mùtúmùwà ọmọ Israẹli lọ àwọn sì lè jẹ àwọn ìrúbọ tí àwọn ọmọ Israẹli làsákálà ò lè jẹ.
But verse 10 is telling us that we have an altar.
Ẹsẹ̀ ìkẹwàá ní àwa ní pẹpẹ kan.
Whereof the high priest of the old covenant and the priests of the old covenant and the Levites of the old covenant and the ministers of the old covenant, they have no right to eat. Those people that were serving the tabernacle, what the least in the kingdom of God, what we have now in the new covenant altar, they did not possess.
Only awa ni pepe kan ninu pepe ti wa o san ju ti majemu lalai tori pe majemu lalai olori alufa awon omo lefi ati awon iranse to nsin ni bi pepe won ko leto lati je ninu nkan to wa ni bi pepe yisu gbon.
And as you begin to think of the great privileges of Aaron, of the high priest, and of the Levites, and you realize that the least in the kingdom now, we go beyond what they had, you'll be praising God for the new covenant.
Olori alufa ati awon omo lefi ti won ni nigba ni sugbon to je pe en to kere julo ni ijoba olorun nisisin yi o ni anfani ju won lo wa ma yin olorun logo
fun. I come to verse 11, for the bodies of those beasts whose blood is brought into the sanctuary by the high priest for sin are burnt without the camp.
Ese ikokanla nitori pe ara awon eran won ni eje ni ti olori alufa mu wa si ibi mimo nitori ese.
Now you see, you need to understand the old covenant. It's not talking about the tabernacle.
Oh, ya ki oye majemu laila waye o on so nipa.
It's talking about the sanctuary.
On so nipa ibi mimo.
It's talking about the camp.
On so nipa ibi ago.
The place of worship of the children of Israel was divided into three.
Ibi ti awon omo Israel tin josin apin si epa.
There was a place where you had the brazen altar where the people that had sinned and had trespassed against the will of the Lord, they'll bring their sacrifices. It's like they wanted forgiveness, they wanted salvation, and the sacrifice will be made for them and the blood will be shed for them, because it is the blood that makes atonement for the soul.
Ibi kan wa ti a bi pepe kan si to je pe awon to ba ti se ninu Israeli won yo mu awon eran won wa lori pepe yi a o pa eran won a o se rubo fun okan won.
But there is a sanctuary, the holy place, and it is not second step now. They will bring their sin offering, which they have gone beyond salvation. They were now doing something which pictures sanctification. They will bring that to the sanctuary, and it was the high priest that will do that.
Ibi mimo kan wa wa ele to je pe ebo ese won won yo mu wa sibe ele to re koja igbala won gbe igbese kan siwaju si olori alfa ni o sise nibe.
And there was the holy of holies.
Ibi mimo julo tun wa wa.
In that one, it was the high priest alone that entered once in a year.
Ekan lodun ni olori alfa sin lati wo be lo.
And there was a kind of partition between the holy place and the holy of holies, and the ordinary priests and the Levites, they couldn't enter into that place. It was reserved for the New Testament people, so that when Jesus died, that thing was pointed to you, and now there is an avenue. There is now a way to enter into the Holy of Holies, or into the holiest of all, and be baptized in the Holy Ghost.
Aso ikele kasi wa ele ti o da ibi mimo ati ibi mimo julo si bi meji ele to je pe awon alufa ati awon omo lefi won ko ni anfani lati kan kugun wo be sugbon nigbati Kristi Oluwa ku aso ikele yi o wa faya ele to wa sile kun gbaya fun iran majemu titun lati wole ki asi baptism wa ninu Oluwa.
But you see that verse 11 we read is talking particularly about the sin offering.
Ni ese kokan lati akaye o nso nipa ebo ese nikan.
Let's read a few Old Testament passages to clear it up for you.
E je ki akade nu majemu lai lai lati je ki oye ko ye o.
In Leviticus chapter 4 from verse 1.
Levitiku ori kerin.
Leviticus chapter 4 verse 1. And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, speak unto the children of Israel, saying, if a soul shall sin through ignorance against any of the commandments of the Lord concerning the things which ought not to be done, and shall do against any of them.
Leviticus ori kerin ese ikini. Oluwa so fun Moses pe so fun awon omo Israel pe bi okan kan ba fi aimose si okan ninu ofin Oluwa li ohun ti ko ye ni sise ti o si se si okan ninu won.
And then in verse 3, if the priest that is anointed do sin according to the sin of the people, then let him bring for his sin which he has sinned a young bullock without blemish unto the Lord for his sin offering.
Ese iketa bi alufa ati afi amoroyan ba se gege bi ese awon eniyan nigba na ni ki o mu egboro ako malu kan alailabuku fun ebo ese fun Oluwa nitori ese ti o ti se.
Remember that these people already, they had been redeemed, they had been saved, they had come out of Egypt, because when I see the blood I will pass over you.
Rati pe awon ta so nipa awon yi ati ra won pada ati mu won jade kuro ni ile Egypt tori majemo Olorun pe nigba ti emi ba ri eje na emi o re won
ko. Now in their relationship with the Lord,
ninu ibasepo won pelu Oluwa,
if anything happened that they now realize they had sinned against the Lord,
so nkan ba wa sele ti won mo pe awon ti se si Oluwa,
a provision was made, and the provision was different from the trespass offering. It was called at the end of verse 3 a sin offering.
Awa ti fi ipese kan sile fun won ele ti o yato si ebo ere koja ninu ese ni a pe ni ebo ese.
In verse 2, if a soul sin, anybody. In verse 3, if the priest that is anointed do sin, a priest.
In verse 13,
if the whole congregation of Israel sin through ignorance.
In verse
22, when a ruler has sinned and done somewhat through ignorance against any of the commandments of the Lord his God concerning the things which should not be done, and is guilty.
Nigbati ijoye kan ba se ti o si fi aimoru okan ninu ofin Oluwa Olorun re ti a kibaru ti o si jebi.
In verse 27, if anyone of the common people sin through ignorance.
Ni ese iketa de ni ogbon bi okan ninu awon eni ile na ba fi aimose.
Now you will see here that provision was made for every one of them. They had been redeemed, they had been saved, but should in case anything happen that they will not be guilty before the Lord again, whether an elder, whether a ruler, whether a priest, whether one of the common people, there was provision for them to offer a sin offering.
O ti ri ipese ti a se sile fun won bayi wi pe ti o ba je pe enikeni ninu won lo se si dese boya olori boya alufa boya omo ijo Israeli nikan tabi enikeni ninu won ati fi ipese fun won lati se irapada okan won.
In the love of God, that provision was made for them so that all that sin can be cleansed away, but there was a special thing: that lamb will be burnt outside the camp.
Ninu ife Olorun ni Olorun fi ipese sile fun won wi pe ki a le ma sanu tabi ki a le dari ese won ju won sugbon kan lo gba akiyesi nibe ni pe eran ti a ba fi se rubo
Look at Numbers chapter 19. Reading from verse 1. It tells us, Numbers chapter 19, verse 1, and the Lord spake unto Moses, and said unto Aaron, and saying, this is the ordinance of the law, which the Lord has commanded, saying, speak unto the children of Israel, that they bring thee a red heifer without spot, wherein is no blemish, and upon which never came yoke, and ye shall give her unto Eleazar the priest, and that he may bring her forth without the camp. You see that? Without the camp, outside the camp, and one shall slay her before his face.
Numeri ori kokandin logun ese ikini Oluwa so fun Mose ati Aaron pe eyi ni ilana ofin ti Oluwa pa lase wi pe so fun awon mo Israeli ki won ki o mu egboro abo malu pupa kan to wa alailabawon ati alailabuku ati lara eyi ti akoti di ajagamo ki eyin si fi fun Eleseri alofa ki on ki o mu jade lo seyin budo sori yen seyin budo ki enikan ki o si pa ni waju re.
And then in verse 9 we're told for the purpose.
Ni ese kesa lati so di re fun wa.
And a man that is clean shall gather up the ashes of the heifer and lay them up without the camp, outside the camp, in a clean place, and it shall be kept for the congregation of the children of Israel for a water of separation. It is a purification for sin.
Ki okunrin kan ki o okunrin kan ti o mo ki o si ko eru egboro abo malu na ki o si ko jo si ibi kan ti o mo leyin budo ki a si pa mo fun ijo awon omo Israeli fun omi iyasapa kan ebo ese ni.
Now you will see here it's talking about something that goes beyond the point of being born again.
Ti o ba kiyesi ni iwari pe o so nkan kan to ju pe kakanda tun bi lo.
A solution is based to teach us the efficacy of the blood of Jesus.
Afiwe yi o lati ko wa nipa agbara tin be ninu eje Jesus.
Because you need to understand from the Old Testament, the people of Israel, they have been looking forward to the Lamb, the final sacrifice, the perfect sacrifice.
Tori ko ye ko yi o pe lati nu majemu lai lai ni awon meseli tin naga wo ebo pipe ebo arofin aruda na.
Abraham said the Lord shall provide himself a lamb for the sacrifice. They were looking forward to the sacrifice, the lamb that will be provided.
Abraham ti so wi pe Oluwa fun ara re yo pese agutan fun ebo na won tin foju sona fun odu agutan na.
And Isaiah said he was oppressed and he was afflicted, he opened not his mouth, he was brought as a lamb to the slaughter. They were looking forward to the lamb.
Isaiah wi pe amu wa gege bi agutan tan fun pipa amu wa be ni ko lenu re daju daju won tin foju sona fun odu agutan ti a o pa lati se.
John said, behold the Lamb of God that taketh away the sin of the world. They were looking forward to the Lamb. They knew that all those sacrifices they were making will stop one day, and Jesus will be the final sacrifice and the perfect sacrifice, and there'll be no need for animal sacrifices anymore.
Jesus Johannu ti wi pe odu agutan na wo odu agutan na eni ti o ko esi araye lo iyan ni pe won tin reti odu agutan pipe ni eleyi ti o la ba won ti o la buku eni ti yo se ebo fun gbogbo esi araye.
Now the sacrifices of the Old Testament, all that is ended now, we now come to Christ, who has made a final perfect sacrifice for sins in the general and then for sin in particular.
Ni bayi ebo ti majemu lai lai o ti re koja ati wa koja sodo Jesu nisisin ti a bi se ebo fun opolopo ese lakopo ati fun ese kan susu.
That leads us now to point number 2.
Ele lo wa mu a lo si koko keji.
Christ sacrifice for our sanctification.
Irubo Christi fun isodi mimo wa.
And look at it in Hebrews chapter 13 and in verse 12.
Iwo wo Eberu ori ketala ese ikejila.
It says, wherefore Jesus also.
O so pe tori na Jesu.
He said in the Old Testament the sacrifice, he said, but now Jesus also.
Since we
are forgiven by the shedding of the blood in the old covenant, but now in the new covenant, Jesus also. The purifying of the heart at that time through the blood that was shed, and then the animal that was taken outside the camp, he said, that is gone. That's the old covenant. But now, Jesus also, that he might sanctify the people with his own blood, suffered without the camp. To start with, he suffered outside the camp. Look at Mark chapter 15. Just to remind you, I'm sure you know this already, that Jesus Christ suffered. He was crucified outside the city of Jerusalem, outside the camp.
Lati le ran leti mo mo pe o mo itan na daada wi pe Jesu Oluwa o jiya a si pa leyin Jerusalem leyin bodi.
Mark chapter 15 verse 20.
Mark orike dogo ese ogun.
And when they had mocked him, they took off the purple from him and put his own clothes on him and led him out. They led him out to crucify him.
Nigbati won si fi sesin tan won si bo aso elesi aluko na kuro lara re won si fi aso re wo won si mu jade.
You see, when he was to suffer for our salvation and sanctification, he was taken outside the camp, he was taken outside the city, so as to be crucified. In verse 22, and they bring him unto the place called the Golgotha, which is being interpreted the place of his skull. In verse 24, when they had crucified him, they parted his garments and cast lots upon them what every man should take.
Nigba ti won si ti kan ma gbele ibutan won si pin aso re won si segege lori won eyi ti olukuluku ibamu.
Hebrews chapter 13 verse 12, wherefore Jesus also, that he might sanctify the people with his own blood, suffered without outside the gate.
Eberu ori keta lese kejila nitori na Jesu pelu ki o le fi eje ara re so awon eniyan di mimo.
Now we know that the death of Jesus Christ radically changes us. And God has not called us only to receive forgiveness. He wants us to be holy. The shedding of the blood of Jesus is not only for salvation, it is also for sanctification. You see, many people today, they talk about forgiveness, they don't talk about regeneration. They talk about new births, they don't talk about new life. They talk about imputed righteousness that Jesus Christ died for us so that he can transfer, he can impute his righteousness unto us. They do not talk about imparted righteousness that becomes part of our life.
Jesus fi fun wa nipa to fi ara re jiya lati mu ododo wa fun araye sugbon won so nipa ododo eleyi ti agbe wo wa.
There are some people that talk about the gospel of success. They do not talk about the fact that we are called to live a holy life, a pure life, that Christ died to save us and to sanctify us.
Awon kan si wa to je pe irere alase yori ka ni aisiki ni won polongo re won kuna lati so nipa igbe aye mimo.
He emphasized Jesus died to make us rich. But they don't understand that that's a small thing, because you spend money only on earth. There is something that Jesus gives you as a result of his death, is salvation and sanctification, holiness, purity of heart that takes you to heaven.
Oye ninu aye lati nawo nigbati abako wojo ana laye ko gbe wa dorun ṣùgbọ́n ohun kan wà tí Jésù fi fún wa ìgbàlà ìsọdí mímọ́ àti ìgbé ayé mímọ́ eléyìí tó fún wa nípa
ikú rẹ̀. Wherefore Jesus also that he might sanctify the people with his own blood he suffered without the gate.
Nítorí náà Jésù pẹ̀lú kí ó lè fi ẹ̀jẹ̀ ara rẹ̀ sọ àwọn ènìyàn di mímọ́ ó jìyà lẹ́yìn ibodè.
The English word sanctify comes from two Latin words.
Ọ̀rọ̀ Gẹ̀ẹ́sì tí a pè ní sọdí mímọ́ ó wá látinú èdè Latin méjì kan.
One part of it means holy. The other part of it means to make. So when you combine the two together, to sanctify means to make holy.
Ayipa akoko o so nipa mimo, ipa ekeji o so nipa lati sodi. To ba wa so mejeje papo, so lati sodi mimo.
So then sanctification is a supreme redemptive act by which Jesus Christ with his own blood makes his saved people holy in heart and holy in life.
Nitori na isodi mimo je ise ori ofe ti irapada ti a se nipasẹ eyi ti Jesu fi eje ara re so àwọn ènìyàn rẹ̀ di mímọ́ nínú ọkàn àti nínú ìgbé ayé wọn.
And it is through the shedding of the blood of Jesus that we are made holy, that we are sanctified, that we are set apart from everything that is polluting, everything that makes us morally dirty.
Nípa ikú Jésù ni a ti wá sọ wá di mímọ́. Ni ayawa si mimo ni ayawa soto patapata kuro lowo idibaje gbogbo.
See what the Bible says, Ephesians chapter 5 from verse 25.
Won ti bibeli so ninu Efesu ori karun ese ikarun
ni Ephesians chapter 5 from verse 25.
Efesu ori karun ese ikarun ni
ogbon. It tells us, husbands love your wives even as Christ also loved the church and he gave himself for the church.
O ni eyin oko e feran awon aya yin gege bi Christ si ti feran ijo.
God so loved the world. That's why he saved the world. God so loved the church, and Christ so loved the church, he gave himself for the church.
Ọlọ́run fẹ́ aráyé tó bẹ́ẹ̀ gẹ́, torí bẹ́ẹ̀ ló ṣe fi ọmọ rẹ̀ fún aráyé láti gba ayé là. Jesu fẹ́ràn ìjọ rẹ̀ tó bẹ́ẹ̀ gẹ́ ló ṣe fi ara rẹ̀ fún ìjọ.
Why did Jesus give himself as a sacrifice, as a perfect final sacrifice in verse 26, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with the washing of water by the word?
Ki wa ni di re ti Jesu Oluwa se fi ara re fun ijo gege bi ebo mimo na lo wa ni ese ikerin ni ogbon ki ohun ki o le so won di mimo leyin ti a ti fi oro we mo ninu
agbada omi. In verse 27, that he might present it to himself a glorious church not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy and without blemish.
Ese iketa ni ni ogbon ki ohun ki o le mu wa sodu ara re bi ijo ti o ni ogo ni aini abawon tabi alebu kan tabi iru nkan ba won ni sugbon ki o le je mimo ati alailabuku.
Sometimes we refer to Latin, sometimes we refer to Greek when we're explaining the word sanctify or sanctification.
Igba miran a le toka sede Latin tabi ede Greek nigba ti a ba nso nipa eso di mimo.
And somebody might say, oh, but I don't know Greek, but I don't know Latin, how will I know that that is the real meaning of the word sanctify?
Awon elomiran a ma fa pa janu wi pe emi o gbede Greek be ni o gbede Latin.
Look at verse 26, that he might sanctify. And then he uses the next word to amplify, to clarify, and to make you understand, and he says, and cleanse it.
O wa lo awon gbolo miran lati le salaye re lati fo wele wele ohun to wa so ni pe lati we mo,
which means to sanctify is to cleanse.
Iyan ni pe si so ni di mimo oni lati we ni mo.
And he's talking about cleansing for members of the church. He's not talking about cleansing for the sinners in the world that need forgiveness. He says Christ gave himself for the church, the people who have been called out of the world, who have been forgiven, who have been born again. Why is he giving himself to sanctify them? What does that mean? To cleanse them.
We were maton soni ijolomba soro. Kuma soni pa awon araye awon to wa nu aye igbala la won nilo sugbon iditi Jesu wa fi ara re fun ijo oni lati we won mo ki o so won di mimo kini tun mo si so di mimo lati we mo.
And then he tells us in verse 27, when the church is saved, that means it's a gracious church, because it's a church that has received grace, that's salvation. But now he tells us, when he sanctifies it and he cleanses it, it goes from just ordinary grace, it goes to a glorious church. From grace to glory, there is a second step.
Oh, one son, yes, I get a name, ni ogba we pe. Nigba ti a ba gba ijo la, ijo wa di ijo olori ofe, ti ori ori ofe, gba lowo oluwa. Sugbon nigba ti Kristi wa fi ara fun ijo bayi, ijo wa tinu ori ofe, o wa di ijo to logo. Iyan ni pe ijo ma ntinu ori ofe, bo sinu ogo igbese keji ni yi.
And it tells us what this sanctification is, not having spot or wrinkle.
O wa so itumo eso di mimo yi fun wa, o ni lai ni abawon tabi alebu.
That is the original stain, the original spot that we brought into the world, which we call by various names, the Adamic nature, or the inbred sin, or the inward sin, or whatever it is that is inside, that original spot, and the wrinkle. You know that wrinkle is the mark of the old man. There is the old nature. Having that wrinkle, it is at sanctification. The Lord will take that away, that now when you are sanctified, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that it should be holy. Sanctification is clear, therefore, and without blemish.
Oh, one so bang by we pay abawa ati alebu eleti ati bewa sinu aye eleti amanpe ni orisirisi oruko a le pe ni eda adamu a le pe ni ese abinibi tabi ese tinu lohun oni nigba ti a ba wa ti o fi ara re fun ijo ohun to wa se ni pe abawon yen ati alebu tin be ninu ijo a wa ti mu kuro ijo nigba na ko wa ni si abawon kankan tabi abukuku kan tabi egan kankan mo.
And so the purpose of the suffering of Christ is so that he might sanctify us, so that he might make us holy, so he might purify our heart, so he might remove every spot, every blemish, every wrinkle, or any such thing, and we become completely, totally holy before the Lord.
Nitori na ete ifare ni rubo Jesu Oluwa oni lati so wa di mimo oni lati fun wa ni okan funfun oni lati wewa mo patapata to bege ti oni si abawon tabi alebu tabi awon abuku kankan ninu aye wa mo.
Then we come back to Hebrews chapter 13 verse 13.
Eje ka wa pada si eberu ori ketala ese ketala.
It tells us in verse 13, let us go forth therefore unto him.
Oni nitori na eje ki a jade to lo.
He said, move from knowledge unto experience.
Oni o kuro ninu imala san bo sinu iriri.
You have learnt about the death of Christ.
O ti ko nipa eku Kristi.
About the sacrifice of Christ.
Nipa erubo Kristi.
And you have learned that he shed his blood. And he shed that blood for our sanctification to make us holy. Then he says, therefore, because he has suffered. He said, therefore, because he shed his blood. So that that blood will not be in vain on your behalf, on my behalf. He said, let us go forth therefore. He's telling us that the sanctification has been provided for the church. It's not only for the apostle. It's not only for the evangelist. It's for all the members of the church. Therefore, he calls on all the members of the church, rise up, let us go forth unto him.
Oni isodi mimo yi ati pese re ki se fun awon apostle nikan tabi awon adari ninu ijo sugba gbogbo omo ijo patapata ni apese re fun e wa je ka dide ki ato lo.
He says, let us go to him outside the camp.
Oni eje ka jade to lo leyin budu.
He said, are we not born again? Are we not children of God? Do you not by faith see your Savior, your sanctifier, crucified outside the camp? Don't you know before you can be sanctified, you need to go to him? But you will go to him outside the camp. You will leave the world. You will leave the Jerusalem pictorially, spiritually. You will leave the world and go to him outside the world. And then you will get to him, you will kneel before him, you will talk to him, you will pray to him. You will despise the insult, the abuse, the persecution, the reproach of the world. You will despise all that. You will go to Christ at all costs, no matter what it means.
Wa fi egan oro alufansa ati oro yeye ti awon aye nfi o se wa fi yen sile laika onkon ti o na wa to lo leyin
bi. You will hold on to Christ and you will say, Lord, you suffered for my sanctification, but I still see impurity inside me. You suffered for my sanctification, I see imperfection inside me. You suffered for my sanctification, you shed your blood. You hold on to him, you allow that blood by faith to drop in your heart and sanctify you, and you hold on to him there, the people of the world, they'll be passing like they were passing when Christ was crucified, and they were making jest of him, they'll be making jest of you. You will not listen to them, you'll be looking unto Christ, you'll be holding on to him. You'll say, except you sanctify me, I will not let you go. Let us go forth therefore unto him outside the camp bearing his reproach.
Nigba na wa fi igbagbo to lo wa si di mu wa takuti lorun wi pe o ti jiya nitori iso di mimo mi nitori na so mi di mimo wa fi okan igbagbo ro mo lai wo egan ati abuku tori pe nigba ti o ba diro mo bayi awon aye yo mo re koja gege bi won tin koja nigba ti akan ma gbele ibu ti won fi Christ seleya sibe sibe aye yo fi iwo na seleya sugbon gbogbo egan ati itiju yi wa pati segbe kan wa fi igbagbo ro ma gbele ibu o wa ni nitori na eje ki a jade to lo leyin bodi.
To go forth outside the camp unto him means that as a believer born again, you break completely from your former life, you break completely from the world, and you turn your back on the world and you go to him outside the camp.
Lati lo si odo Christ leyin bodo o tumo si pe ki onigbagbo se iyapa patapata kuro ninu igbe aye re atijo ati ko se iyapa patapata kuro lodo awon elegan ati awon elese ninu aye ko to
olo. You renounce everything that is opposed to Christ.
Wa ko gbogbo to ba ta ko Christ wa ko sile.
You will not be a relative of Judas Iscariot that betrayed him. You will not be a relative of the Pharisees that took him. You will not be a Pharisee, a relative of the people that were saying crucify him. You come out from among them. You leave all those people, all the people that are making jest of Christ. You come out of that world and you go outside the camp. You identify with Christ outside. That is your consecration that will make you to be sanctified.
Oko ni darapo mo awon ibatan Judasi eni ti o ta oluwa re be lo ni je ninu awon egbe awon farisi awon ti won kan ti won mu ti won si kan ma gbelebu o ni si lara awon egbe awon eniyan ti won fi Christ seleya ti won bi fi Christ sesin wa jade ko laarin won ni ji jade to ba jade ko laarin won wa to lo leyin budo eleyi ni ifare ni je ti o je ko ni iso di mimo.
In that place it says bearing his reproach.
Ni ese yi lo wa ni ki a ma ru egan re.
Bearing his reproach,
ki a ma ru egan re.
That means if Christ were on us today, there is a way they will reproach him because he's not on earth and you are on earth. You are the Christian having a name similar to that of Christ, a follower of Christ. The reproach of Christ will fall upon you. You will bear it.
O wa so gbangba pe ti Christ ba ma wa laye nisisin yi awon eniyan won yo ma fi sesin won yo ma fi se eleya sugbon nitori pe Christ o si laye nisisin yi bayi iwo la soju re ti a npe ni Christiani nitori pe oruko re ti wa jo oruko Christi egan Christi yo wa subulu o wa ma ru awon egan na.
You will endure ridicule.
Wa farada isoro.
You will bear the persecution of the world.
Inu ni bi ni aye wa farada.
You will put on the badge of the reproach of Christ.
Wa fi ami egan Christi wa gbe wo sorun ara re.
You will submit to whatever insult, whatever false accusation the people of the world may put upon you because you are now identified with Christ. You want sanctification at all costs. You say, I don't care what they say. I don't care what they do. All I want is I want to be purified. I want to be holy. I want to be made ready for heaven.
Wajo wara re fun egu tabi esun eke ti awon araye le ma fi ko idi ti wa ti farada ni pe o ti nipinu okan pe ohun ti o ba gba ni wa fi fun ni ti isoji mimo yi o fe gba nitori na wa ma ru egan Christi.
The flesh will be crucified. All its affections will be crucified. All the lusts will be crucified. You will bear your cross. You will daily, diligently follow him, whatever the world may say, whatever the world may do. Because we're told in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 25, verse 26. Choosing rather to suffer affliction with the people of God than to enjoy the pleasures of sin for a season.
For
the people are going to accuse you. They say that you don't find another church to go. That place, the holy, holy church, the sanctification church, the heavenly minded church, the people that don't do any function, any society with the people of the world, that's the church you have joined. You will bear the reproach of Christ. If you really want to have this ticket that goes to heaven, you have your Lord, you have your path, or the people of God, even though they are despising us.
Esteeming
the reproach of Christ greater riches than the treasures of Egypt.
Okay, gan Christ si oro ti o poju awon esura Egypt.
You will count the insult, you will count the abuse, you will count the persecution, something more precious, something greater than all the salary, than all the money, than all the property you can get from the world. You rejoice that the reproach of Christ has fallen upon you. That's the time you are getting ready. You want the Lord to sanctify you, or if he has sanctified you, you are able to keep the sanctification because you do not mind what the world may do to you.
Nigba ti awon aye ba n fi ose sin wa ka esin ati alebu ti won fi n kan ati egan ati ohun ko ti on gba lowo re wa ka si ayo nitori pe o mo pe awon eleyi ti o ti ri gba ti se yi ai ni pekun o lagbara o si poju awon nkan ti o n farada ninu aye tori be ti o ba ti ni isodi mimo wa le pa isodi mimo yi mo o ni je ko bo sonu tori pe o mo pe o ni iwe irina si orun.
In 1 Peter chapter 4 verse 4.
Peteru kini ori kerin ese ikerin.
Wherein they think it strange that ye run not with them to the same excess of riot, speaking evil of you. That's the reproach.
Eyi ti o ya won lenu pe eyin ko ba won sure sinu iru aseju iwa wo bi awon.
They will gossip about you. They will make fun of you. They will call you names. They will call you deeper, but the deeper they are calling is a nickname that they call you. But you know he says, let us go forth unto him, bearing his reproach. In verse 14, if ye be reproached for the name of Christ, happy are ye. Because when you bear that reproach, for the spirit of glory and of God resteth upon you on their part, is evil spoken of on your part, is glorified. You know why many people are saved and they are not sanctified? Because although they are born again, they do not take sanctification very serious, and yet Jesus took it so serious. He died, he shed his blood outside the camp, and he bore the shame and the reproach so we can be sanctified. Because they do not realize that if they are not sanctified, the root of sin within can grow up again and begin to bring up branches and eventually later bring actual sin that can damn your soul.
Tori pe oye oye won wi pe ti o ko ba tete kegbe fun isodi mimo ese ti nbe ni inu yen gbogbo ikoro re tun le so jade ko tun peka.
Or because some people are not so serious, they are not so committed, they are not so yielded, they are not so surrendered, they want to be sanctified, but they pray a 2-minute prayer and they say, by and by, Jesus, when you are ready, you can sanctify me, and see what Jesus went through, see the agony and see the suffering and see the shedding of his blood, and you take it so easy. You will pray and you will pray with all your heart, with all the agony and the desire in your heart. You will agonize, say, no Lord, this root of sin within, today is the time you are going to remove it. If you are so serious like that and you are willing to commit and consecrate everything to the Lord will sanctify you.
sugbon adura seju meji pere won ti o ti sun won ninu adura won a ma ro ninu ara won pe nigba to ba wo Christi fun ara re yo so mi di mimo won ti Jesus se wo iya to je owo to lagbara ti Jesus fi mu iwo na fi mu ko taku ti Olorun lorun wi pe Olorun o lati so kan mi di mimo ko kerora ninu adura to ba ni iru ikerora ati edun kan be wa ni so di mimo.
Wherefore Jesus also that he might sanctify the people.
Nitorina, ki Jesus ki o le so awon eniyan di mimo.
Who are the people?
Awon wo le ni na?
Are those the people in Jerusalem, the people who are sinners, the people who have never known him? No, the people who are part of the church, those who are born again, his people.
Se awon ti won wa ni Jerusalem, awon ti won wa ninu aye ti won o ti da to bi ni rara awon eniyan re.
Are you part of his people?
Sare eniyan re ni.
I said, are you part of his people?
Mo ni sare eniyan re ni.
When Jesus wants to give you something, then you fold your hand and you hold to yourself and you say, Jesus, take it away, I don't want it.
Nigba ti Jesus ba fe fun ni nkan kan to fe ta Olore se wa kawo gbera wa ni ma mu lo ngun fe bi.
Even those of us who are ordinary human beings like me, if I wanted to give you something that I labored for, that I bought at a great price, that I suffered for, and I want to show my love to you, and I give it to you as ordinary as I am, you will be so happy, you will get it. Look at Jesus Christ, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. He saw that your sanctification is so important and is so precious, and he suffered outside the gate, and he comes here tonight and he says, you are born again, you are a child of God, are you not ready for sanctification? And he stretches it out to you, and in a hurry you run out of the hall, you don't get it. Don't you know that slighting the Lord Jesus Christ? You will not do that.
Oh my pe emi eniyan lera ara lasan ti mo ba ni ebun rere kan eti mo lagun fun eti mo sise fun ti mo se laala si ko to temi lowo ti mo wa fe fi ife mi han si o lati fi ebun na tan Olore mo mo yi pe iwo tinu tinu toyaya toyaya ni wa fi fe gba lowo mi wa ro ti Jesu oba awon oba oluwa awon oluwa ro iya to je o lo seyin ibode o jiya ajeniya nigba na o wa wa lale yi o lo fe fun eni so di mimo o wa nawo e so di mimo fun e o wa fe sa jade ko ma lo tete kanju lo sile mo mo pe oni se be lale
yi. He suffered without the gate for you and for me.
O jiya leyin bode nitori ti ati temi.
Let us go forth therefore.
Nitori na e je ka jade.
Are we ready? Let us go forth therefore.
E sa mura te je ka jade to.
Let us go forth therefore.
E je ka jade to.
We don't care for what the world may say.
A o bi kita
da yo so. We don't care for their insults. We don't care for their persecution. Let us go forth therefore.
Nitori na e je ka jade
to. Unto Christ. He's waiting for you. Unto Christ. He wants to give you unto him. He wants to sanctify you unto him. Without the camp, outside the wall, outside the dancing hall, outside the merriment, outside the jesting of the world, turn your back on the world and consecrate yourself and give yourself. Let us go therefore unto him without the camp, bearing his reproach. He wants to sanctify you. You've been saved for a long time. He wants to sanctify you. Your sins have been forgiven and cleansed away. He wants to take the Adamic nature, the root of sin, the stony heart, the inbred sin. He wants to take it away. He wants to make you holy within, pure within. He wants to sanctify you. He wants to operate on you and take away the stony heart. He wants to give you the heart of flesh. He wants to circumcise your heart. He wants you to be without spot and without wrinkle and without any such thing. He wants you to be holy and without blemish. He wants to make you like Enoch. He wants to give you the life and the heart of Enoch. He wants to sanctify, purify, perfect you. All those things that are coming out, stirring up in the heart, he wants to take it away. He wants to cleanse. He wants to purge. He wants to purify with the blood he shed for you on the cross of Calvary. Let us go forth therefore unto him. Let us go forth therefore unto Christ. He's waiting for you. Come under the cross. The blood of Jesus is dripping down. Come under the blood of the Lamb. And the blood will cleanse. And the blood will sanctify. And the blood will purify. And the blood will make you holy. Let us go forth unto him without the camp bearing his reproach. You will not run away from the Lord because of persecution. Because they are making jest of you. Because they are insulting you. Go fast unto the Lord. Remain with the Lord. And you will never leave him. And once he gives you that sanctification, you will keep it until the trumpet will sound.